There is some good news coming from Tesla Gigafactory Nevada related to Tesla Panasonic batteries expansion and adding 100 new battery workers. Welcome back, dear friends. This is Armin Harayan from torquenews.com. Please subscribe to our channel if you would like to see daily Tesla and electric vehicle news, and please ring the bell so you don't miss my next Tesla story. Jason Hidalgo has a very interesting local good journalism story published in Reno Gazette Journal talking about Panasonic expanding at Tesla Gigafactory and saying that Panasonic plans to add 100 workers, and it's confirmed by an executive. He has an interview with the executive there, and I'm going to talk about that. But I first want to note that this is all happening just about 2 weeks before the Tesla battery day. Yesterday I reported that Tesla is starting to recycle batteries and swap batteries in China. This is another news that we will probably hear more in the battery day, and now Panasonic expanding. So things are looking bright in my opinion. And so Hidalgo writes that Panasonic is supercharging its efforts at Tesla Gigafactory 1 with a major expansion of its operations, including investment in new infrastructure for making higher capacity batteries with lower costs. There is some construction workers that needs to take place over the next couple of months. Carl Walton, Vice President of Production, Engineering and Facilities for Panasonic Energy of North America, confirmed to Reno Gazette Journal. Then, early next year, we'll be installing new equipment with production starting shortly after that. Then Hidalgo writes that additional capacity will come from a 14th production line that Panasonic is adding to the Gigafactory in Nevada. The new line, which is the 14th, the new line is expected to significantly boost capacity at the site. We're talking about battery capacity, which is at 35 gigawatt hours per year prior to this expansion. That means right now. Walton declined to Reno Gazette Journal to share the exact number of additional gigawatt hours that the expansion will add, but said the company expects capacity to increase by about 10%. Now, if you have 13 lines and they are about 35 gigawatt hour per year, now adding one line makes sense to increase about 10 years. Now, Reno Gazette Journal also reports that Panasonic also plans to hire more employees. The Gigafactory employs about 7,000 workers, with Panasonic and Tesla accounting for the bulk of workers, according to Walton. Here's a quote. "The expansion will increase our staffing by about 100 positions," Walton said. "We are excited to continue our investment in the northern Nevada community and our people here." Reno Gazette Journal also says that expansion will recharge Panasonic and Tesla partnership. And yes, it will. The expansion represents a doubling down by Panasonic on the Gigafactory following uncertain about its future plans for the site. A little over a year ago, the Nikkei Asian Review reported that Tesla and Panasonic were looking to freeze expansion plans for the massive battery factory due to the potential risk. Panasonic Chief Executive Officer Kazuhiro Tsuga also expressed concern about Tesla CEO Elon Musk's, I'm putting this in quote, "unpredictable behavior" during an earnings briefing in October 2018, according to Reuters. Musk, meanwhile, reports Reno Gazette Journal, called out Panasonic in a tweet last year, blaming its battery partner for Tesla's reticence to further boost investment at the facility. The Tesla CEO claimed that Panasonic has not been able to ramp up capacity to adequate levels, which Musk says was constraining production of its Model 3 electric vehicle. Now, fast forward to the present. If you remember, earlier this year, we reported some good news that the relationship was improving, the relationship became profitable, and now fast forwarding to the present, the relationship between Panasonic and Tesla regarding to their battery business looks to be a much firmer ground. Demand was cited by Panasonic and Energy of North America President Alan Swan last year as the main driving force for any future Gigafactory expansion during a one-on-one interview with the Reno Gazette Journal. I will provide the link to that interview in the description of this video so you guys can watch it. It's a 9-minute interview, very interesting. Walton echoes Swan's comment and credit that increased electric vehicle adoption for Panasonic's decision to move forward with the expansion plan. Here is a quote from Walton. The electric vehicle market throughout the world continues to explode and the demand is there, Walton said. This is our way of helping our partner Tesla to continue supplying electric vehicles to the market. Now, Panasonic gets one step closer to cobalt-free batteries. This is a good news. Reno Gazette Journal Hidalgo writes that Panasonic's expansion plans are not limited to adding a production line. The expansion will also be accompanied by upgrades to its existing facilities at the Gigafactory. And it's very good that they're getting closer to cobalt-free batteries because cobalt is expensive and mining cobalt is very questionable. The upgrades are necessary in order to accommodate Panasonic's new battery technology, according to Walton. That work is starting now, and we have already started to convert current equipment to be able to make those batteries for us, Walton said to Reno Gazette Journal. Hidalgo also writes that the new battery technology checks off two boxes mentioned by Elon Musk when talking about increased adoption of electric vehicles, battery capacity, and the cost. And we're going to hear, hopefully, on both of these questions, these two check marks, at the battery day. Everybody is going to see what the battery capacity that Tesla can get is, and also what's the cost that Tesla can get a battery per 1 kilowatt hour. Is it less than $100 or still more expensive than $100 per kilowatt hours? Because that's the parity level. Range and improved affordability, Hidalgo continues in his article, are especially crucial when it comes to competing against traditional gas-powered vehicles, making them essential for boosting electric vehicle adoption. Hidalgo also says battery capacity and cost are also expected to factor into an anticipated announcement by Musk during Battery Day, like I said, and the Battery Day, an event that the Tesla CEO plans to hold this month on September 22nd. In my personal opinion, I think this Battery Day is one of Tesla's most important events of 2020, and we're going to all look forward to see what announcements will come there from there. Panasonic's latest battery improves energy density by 5%, writes Hidalgo in Reno Gazette Journal, from its previous battery. 5% the energy density improvement from its previous battery. Panasonic also claims, according to Reno Gazette Journal, that it is 1.4 times denser than competing iron phosphate batteries, which would make it the world's highest density battery. The company goal is to eventually increase the energy density of its batteries by 20%. Simon Alvarez writes in Tesla Radi saying that with the recent statement from Walton, however, it appears that both companies now stand on much firmer ground. Panasonic's expansion of its Gigafactory Nevada operations seem to be a strong strategy this year, after all, especially since its battery business in the Tesla facility has proven profitable even from January to March 2020, a time that is marred by the start of the virus, and with electric cars becoming more popular, the Japanese firm Panasonic will likely have its hands full trying to meet battery demands for Tesla electric vehicles. No wonder Panasonic will be adding 100 more jobs to the Gigafactory in Nevada. Well, friends, this is exciting news. Because this news may have some market implications, I want to state that I'm not in the market. I don't have any stocks. I'm just reporting Tesla and automotive news. And in the meantime, this is Armin Harayan from TorqueNews.com. Please subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla news. And let me know what your thoughts are about Panasonic-Tesla relationships growing. And I have very interesting news coming after this. It appears that Volkswagen CEO Herbert Diess also test drove the Model Y, and I'm going to tell you in my next story, in my next report, what he said about test driving the Model Y. It just came in our news teletypes. So please subscribe to our channel, and I'll see you soon in our next report. God bless you. Take good care of each other. Have a wonderful rest of the week. I'll see you soon in a few minutes.